What's up, YouTube? I'm Mr. No Name, or Max, as people know him in the real world, and today I'm bringing you guys my competitive classes for the GB variant SND rule set, non-radar, of course. And yeah, that's what this is going to be today. I'm going to be going over specialists to be using in SND as well, and score streaks. This GB variant rule set just came out a little bit ago. It was earlier today, and I was going to make it earlier, but we played a few matches first to just kind of get back into things, but this is the 8th of November for those of you watching it in the future, so I'm sure, because I know the rules are going to change some more, so, but this is in accordance to those rules, and I'll update classes as the rules change. So getting right into it, first class here is going to be the XR2 with Elo Sight, Quick Draw, and Rapid Fire. So explanation here, XR2 is a burst assault rifle. It's basically a better version of the M8 right now because the M8 got nerfed so much from the beta. You'll see people using it a lot. Elo Sight is personal preference, but you'll see a lot of people actually using that right now. It's a lot like the Reflex Sight. It's just, in my opinion, a better sight overall. Quick Draw, of course, you know, that's pretty standard on ARs. And then Rapid Fire, unfortunately, is what we are using right now because Rapid Fire is not banned yet. You'll want Rapid Fire on every single weapon that you use. You don't need anything else on this weapon, really. I mean, if you really wanted to, you could put on stock, but it's not necessary on this game, really. And then we've got a frag and a concussion. Frag for nade spots and checking bombs, and then concussion for pushes. If you stun somebody in this game, you're going to win the gunfight. It's as simple as that. It's absolutely overpowered, and it needs to be nerfed or permanently banned, to be completely honest. Like, it's that strong. Perk 1 is empty. Then Fast Hands, and then Dead Silence, and Blast Suppressor. You'll see some people opt to change Blast Suppressor for Awareness. In my opinion, it's not that good. It could be because my headset is not as strong as Astro's right now because, you know, my Astro's broke. But personal preference here is to use Blast Suppressor and Dead Silence simply because then you're completely silent and you can just, you know, thrust around as much as you want. You can take off a nade or stun in case you need Flak Jacket if they're using a lot of nades, if you're just getting naded off bomb and things, so that is something to look for. Next class is the Razorback. So Razorback is still, in my mind, a good gun, but it's not as good as I thought it initially was. But we've got Rapid Fire, Long Barrel, and Quick Draw. You do not need grip on this gun, that's for sure, and you don't need a sight. Trust me, it's absolutely fine without either of those two things. Then a stun, Fast Hands, Blast Suppressor, and Dead Silence. Moving on, Man of War. So Man of War can be interchanged with the ICR. It all depends on connection. I'm going to be 100% honest. If you are host, the ICR is probably better. If you're not host, Man of War is probably better. But same attachments for both guns of Elo Sight, Quick Draw, Grip, and Rapid Fire. Maybe on the ICR you could get away with not using Grip. But on Man of War, you definitely need it, especially with that Rapid Fire. And then, of course, Fast Hands, Dead Silence, and Blast Suppressor. Moving on to next one, Dingo here. So this is the LMG. Initially, I thought the Gorgon was really, really good, but it's not as good as I thought. Use the Dingo. It's overall better because of the fire rate, to be completely honest. Thermal Sight, Quick Draw, Grip, and Rapid Fire. Please note that thermal sights on LMGs apparently take away any sort of aim assist, kind of like snipers. I don't know if that works with assault rifles yet, I haven't tried it, but that's what happens on LMGs, so your aim assist is not there, so keep that in mind. But this gun is basically a laser beam with this setup here, and then of course, Fast Hands, Blast Suppressor, and Dead Silence. Next one is my VMP class. So you got VMP, Quick Draw, Grip, and Rapid Fire, and then this concussion here, I will change this out sometimes for a smoke, and just so you guys know, when you walk into smoke on this game, you are taken off the radar. So like, if you're playing a radar match and you throw a smoke down and you walk into the smoke, you're not on radar anymore, so that's just something to note. But sometimes a smoke here, and then Fast Hands, Dead Silence, and Blast Suppressor. This class is extremely overpowered right now. This gun is exceptionally strong. I'm sorry. It's like, if you're a sub player, if you're an OBJ player, this is the gun you want to be using. You will kill people extremely quickly. It's absolutely insane how fast this gun kills. You do have to have some gun skill though, because it's hard even with grip to control that recoil a little bit. So keep that in mind. So those are the classes, really, that you want to be using right now. Of course, this is only a couple days in. Things will change, but there are a couple other things to go over here. So first thing, going into specialist. So a few things have been banned now, but I'm going to go over what I think is probably the best for S&D right now. So going through it, gravity spikes is okay. It's not great, but it's okay. Overdrive, not really necessary, in my opinion. Vision pulse is banned. Sparrow is alright. I mean, some people like it. I personally don't like using it at all. But if you know where somebody is and you want to try and, you know, stick a wall with it and explode behind them, or if you just think you can hit it, it's fine, I guess. But I would use probably Annihilator over Sparrow. Just my personal preference there. Glitch is alright. However, it's hard to actually use it properly. It's going to take a lot of training yourself to actually use it. Tempest, not really that good. I would stay away from it. War Machine, not necessary. Kinetic Armor is banned. Annihilator is okay. Combat Focus is not good at all. Annihilator is just... I prefer Annihilator over Sparrow, like I said before. It's just a pistol that's one shot. You know, it's fine as is. And then Rejack and Hive are banned now. Thank God. That was so terrible. Scythe is alright, but I don't really see the point of it when you have Annihilator. And then Psychosis is good. That's actually what I've been using recently. And then Ripper, there's no point. Active Camo doesn't last long enough. Purifier is okay in Hardpoint, but it's not okay in S&D, really. There's just no point. And then I haven't really tried Heatwave, but I don't imagine it being that great. But it's possible, so you can give it a try if you want. And then as far as score streaks go, you want the HCXD. If you guys didn't know, you can jump with it, so, you know, make sure you're doing that. Guardian, and then not Lightning Strike, Hellstorm, because Lightning Strike is special in this game right now. It doesn't seem to work very well. And if you think you can go even higher if you're playing four-man, then you can maybe go for a Century, because, you know, then you just have the complete lockdown. But it's completely up to you on that. So yeah, those are the classes that you guys want to be using. So as you guys can see, we're coming to the end of this video. If you enjoyed it, then please like, comment, and or subscribe. If you didn't, then let me know what I can do better next time. Constructive criticism goes a long way, guys. Until next time, everybody, peace out.